We will now have Kei Liu from the Shanghai Jiaotong University to present smartphone-based handwritten signature verification using acoustic signals. Please share your screen and
okay.
Begin when you're ready.
Thanks for your introduction. And hello, everyone. It's my honor to present our work, the smartphone-based handwritten signature verification using acoustic signals. The handwritten signature is one of the oldest biometric authentication for paper-based documents, which can represent the identity of a person and the intention of that person, has been commonly accepted and widely used in business, financial, and legal areas. And nowadays, signature methods can be divided into offline methods and online methods. The offline methods scans the static images for verification, while the online methods using a special device to capture dynamic handwritten patterns when signing. Existing online methods usually touch or wear either a special signature device, such as a sensor instrumented pen, a tablet, a glove, or a smartwatch. However, these additional special devices restrict the practicability of these online approaches. Smartphones with various built-in sensors have become indispensable in our lives, which open up new possibilities for online signature verification. Although there are already some existing work that leverage in audible acoustic signals to capture action patterns for activity recognition, automatic handwriting signature verification using acoustic signals has not been fully explored. To achieve a signature verification, a feasible method is to leverage a smartphone to transmit in audible acoustic signals, which means the frequency range is about 18 to 22 kilohertz, and record echo signals reflected by handwriting actions to capture handwritten behavior characteristics and physical characteristics. And before describing our handwriting signature verification system, I want to envision its application scenarios at first. To begin with, it can verify signatures automatically and immediately. And when performing online signature verification, users don't need to carry some unusual devices, but only smartphones. And in addition, it can serve as an assistant or additional handwriting signature verification approach in a two-factor authentication system. However, there are some challenges to fulfill this system. The first is the hand motion of signature is so tiny, and we use CIR, that is channel impulse response, to capture these features. And we design a special upsampled GSM sequence to expand the signal's sensing range. After getting the signature motion features, we proposed an attentional multi-modal Siamese network to do a verification. The network can achieve a good performance by emphasizing the interpersonal variability and accommodating interpersonal variability. And in the second part, I will talk about some details about our system, SonarSign. Here is an overview about SonarSign. It consists of four major components, including two signal collection modules, acoustic signals transceiver, and CIR estimation, as well as one CIR information pre-processing module, and one deep learning module, signature verification. And the pipeline of this term is, at first, the speaker on the smartphone sends out the signals, and the microphone receives the echo signals. After receiving the echo signals, CIR estimation is performed, and multimodal information is extracted. Then it will be fed into the network mode to perform a verification. The key of the first module is the design of signal. The baseband we select is GSM sequence. It has 26 bits, and we pad 14-bit zero symbols in its tail to prevent frame corruption. Then we upsampled the baseband 12 times to expand the sensing range and ensure the range resolution. The sensing range increased to 42.85 centimeters, and the range resolution is 0.354 centimeters. Then we modulate the signal to an audible frequency range. After that, the signal can be played through the speaker. And the microphone in smartphone can record the echo signals. After recording the echo signals, SonarSign downsamples echo signals to the baseband with standard IQ demodulation, then performs CIR estimation. The figure in the right is the visualization of CIR. The x-axis represents time, and the y-axis represents steps, which represents the propagation path of signals. Here, we do an experiment to demonstrate the feasibility of using CIR to extract dynamic motion features. Two participants are asked to write the same signature many times, and the results show DCIR from the same participant for the same signature exhibits similar patterns, which demonstrates the stability and repeatability of the handwritten signatures, while DCIR of forged signatures shows apparently different patterns to genuine ones, and this discrepancy is large enough to distinguish them from each other. And the last part is the deep learning module. Here we propose an attentional multi-modal Siamese network. The input of this network is a pair, including evaluation sample and the enrollment sample. For each sample, three modality is extracted before. The network has two branches which sharing ways with each other to perform the same feature extract process. Every branch has three CNN subnets, which serve as feature extractor for three different modality. After extracting the advanced features from input sample, an attentional module is followed to align the two feature embeddings. Finally, a full connection layer is followed to compute a result. By this pipeline, we got the final result. And in the third part, I will talk about some details about evaluation. The first is the information of data sets. We collect two data sets. One is basic data set, and the other is unseen user data set. For basic data set, it contains 23 participants. And for each participant, he or she has 40 positive samples written by him or herself. And 35 skilled forged samples imitated by others. For unseen user datasets, it includes 12 participants which are not shown in basic datasets, and each one has 20 genuine signatures and 8 skilled forged signatures. We use AOC and EER to evaluate the performance of system. A good handwriting signature verification system will have a high AOC with a low EER value. And the picture below shows the scene when collecting this. And first, we perform five-fold cross-validation on basic dataset. And we got AOC equals to about 99%, and the EER is about 3.27% on average. These results manifest that the SonarSign can effectively distinguish the legitimate signatures from forged ones. Also, we test it on unseen user datasets, and we got AOC about 98%, and the EER is 5.79%. It demonstrates our system can extract generalized features of handwritten signatures, even for unseen participants. We also compare our methods with some existing methods using acoustic signals. By testing on the same dataset, the results show our system has better performance. Besides, we test our system on different positions and orientations. The results show it can still perform well within the appropriate variation range. And some environmental interference is also considered. In practical scenarios, there may be a pass-by or music playing when someone sends. To superpose influence from these environment factors may affect the system performance. These experimental results also show the robustness of our system. Then we do some macro benchmark tests, including different network models, different modalities, and a number of participants in training sets to demonstrate the effectiveness about our system. Okay, in conclusion, we elaborate an automatic handwritten signature verification system using handwritten signature patterns captured by inaudible acoustic signals with commercial off-the-shelf smartphones, and extensive experimental results envision that SonarSign can conveniently, correctly, and robustly verify a signature. However, there are still some works waiting to explore, such as compatibility on different smartphones, accuracy for signatures with a longer time span, and the combination with other verification approaches. There are works that need to be done in the future. Okay, that's all. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your talk. It looks like a really nice system that can come in handy quite often. Are there any immediate questions in the audience or in the chat? Okay, then I would like to ask a question. Did you consider different languages? Because there are some languages that are written from left to right to left, top to down. Some are one fluent motion, other are different single strokes. So did you consider that, if that will have an impact or?
But the scenario we consider is the normal thing, which means you sign your signatures in a normal way, just like what you do in the lab. There's no strange situations here.
Okay, so it should, or your model should work independent of the language the person is signing with.
Our paper mentions the signing in Chinese as the dataset collector. The signatures are written in English, and it's shown the performance. The EER value has growth, and you know the lower the value of EER, the lower the better. But the value increased. But if you use some transfer learning methods, which means you offer some some samples written in Chinese, and the results will be better.
Okay, thank you. Are there any questions from the audience? Well, if not, I'm going to ask a second one. What are the implications for your system? So are you actually planning on having this system installed on personal smartphones? So if you sign a contract with someone, you get out your smartphone and basically check that it's basically them signing, or what are basically your implications for the future? How will the system be used?
We suppose the scenarios is that when people need to sign important documents, he or she can put the smartphone aside and then sign. The smartphone will upload the recorded audio information to a qualified company or institutions for authentication, which means the inference of the network model is not executed in the phone in practical scenarios. It will be run in the server of qualified company or institutions. This ensures fairness and security.
Okay, yeah, that also takes care of another question I had, how to distribute these patterns, but if it's centralized, then that takes care of that. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
So there's a question. Yes.
Thank you for the presentation. I just wanted to ask, from the moment you used the CNN, did you consider the false positive or true negatives in the classification?
Sorry, can you speak a bit louder?
Yeah, I can repeat the question. So when you basically with the CNN, did you consider the false negatives in any form?
So what do you mean false negatives? Is it the negative samples?
I mean, maybe when you test your model, maybe when you have accuracy, maybe for some samples, he suggested that they were true, but that there wasn't the right signature. Was it measured?
So basically, if a signature that was forged was recognized as a correct signature.
Do you mean what signature can be regarded as a forged signature? The first signature is the signature emitted by the emitters, which means it is not signed by the correct user.
Yes, but did the system recognize one of these signatures falsely as the correct signature? I think that was the question.
The thing may be occur. You know, the AI system can't access the 100% accuracy. It must be happened, and we can't prevent it.
Okay. Well, does that answer your question? Thank you.
And then we're
out of time, so we would go through this to the third talk. Thank you very much again.